We come before your throne. Father, we just thank you for this beautiful night of ministry, God. We thank you, God, that you just allow us to come together as a church family. The Open Door Skid Row Ministry, God, that you planted in this community. We're celebrating 16 years this year, God. So, Father, we know that it's only you that keeps a ministry going that long. Father, we know it's only you that provides, Father, so that we can bring food, God, so that we're able to do pizza night, God, because that pizza costs money. All they want is the dollar. But, Father, whatever our need is, you make that you provided, God. If we need money, you make that money, God. If we need peace, God, you're the one that gives us peace. If we need joy, God, you're the one. Joy comes from you, God. If we need love, God, we can stop looking for love in all the wrong places. And we can draw nigh unto you, because you told us that we draw nigh unto you. You draw nigh unto us, God. And you're the one that created love. So, Father, we just say thank you for being God all by yourself. Thank you for being a beautiful, wonderful, that you expect love from us, God. You're not expecting evil, and you don't give us that, God. You give us the real deal, and the real love comes from you. Father, we just say thank you so much for being here. Nothing else is real in our life, God. We know we can count on you, God. We just come to praise you, to say that we love you and honor you and adore you in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Let all that agree with that prayer say amen. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. Amen. If you only got one person you can count on, and you don't need nobody else, amen. How many of you know you can always count on God? You can count on God, amen. So we're not going to be before you long. Tonight is going to be a quick night. As you see, we're going to do pizza tonight, so we got to go pick it up when it's nice and hot. Amen. But before we do, we always like to open up with worship songs, because how many know that, you know, it's something about worshiping God, and it lifts your spirit. Anybody need their spirit lifted up? Amen. Well, all you got to do is just recognize that he's the Lion of Judah. How many know he's the Lion, the Great I Am? Come on, you might as well get your praise on, get your hallelujah on, get your glory to God.
You are my Lord and King.
You are my Lord and King.
The Lion of.
to me. That's what he's saying. And really what he's saying is, if you lift up love, do you guys know love draws? If you lift up the banner of love, people are drawn to love, amen? Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise.
Amen.
Amen. We all want love. That's how God designed us. We want love,
amen?
We're looking for love. This is one song that we used to sing. I think we're going to sing it tonight. I'm like, we're going to sing this song because the Lord just, you know, we're all looking for love. Aren't we looking for love? We're going to sing it. I didn't plan it, but we're going to do it anyway. We're going to do it anyway. What you looking for? What you looking for? Where are the other people at? He talking about me. He said young people. just wanted to throw that song in there.
This song is so crazy.
We didn't really know that song, but that's okay. We used to sing that song on the corner of 5th and San Pedro when we was out on the sidewalk doing a sidewalk church. We had that sidewalk lit up. People was getting off the bus singing. They had no intention of going to church on the sidewalk. But how many of you know God will meet you where you're at? He'll meet you where you're at. He told us to come as we are, but he will meet us where we are.
At.
He will come. He comes to the jail.
Yes, he does.
Or house, Abraham.
Yes, he does.
Amen.
Don't tell me. He comes after us. Amen. We just like to encourage everybody to just make sure you're holding on to God. Amen. Amen. So this song just encourages us to hold on. woman, if you believe everything gonna be all right, then we should be rejoicing, amen? We should be shouting hallelujah right now, amen? Don't wait for the battle to be over to start shouting. You gotta get that engine churning now, amen? Amen. Just make sure that you're holding on to God's unchanging hand. Everything else changes. God is not changing, not. Amen. You want to make sure whose hands you're holding on. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand, praise. Amen. Can we give the Lord a hand, praise? Amen. Amen. We sang this song on Sunday. It was a beautiful, it's just a beautiful reminder that name, something about that name, Jesus. Amen. It's something about just the mention of his name that is just so beautiful. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Jesus, it's just something about the mention of that name.
Yes.
You say that name, Jesus, and stuff just, it changes the atmosphere.
Yes, it does.
It changes the atmosphere.
Yes, it does.
Amen. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. I gotta find the right one. Let's see if this is good. Amen. Ooh, you guys are petty making God. Come on, let's give the Lord. That the more you praise God, the more He gives you to be thankful for. And praise is what brings in your blessing. Amen. We've heard this said all the time that when the praises go up,
blessings.
So let's make sure during our day, the best time to give God praise is when you first wake up in the morning. Because how many of you know ain't nobody but God waking us up in the morning?
Amen.
Yes, that ain't the devil waking us up in the morning unless you're a hellraiser. But God wakes us up in the morning so that we can, He gives us and starts us with a new day. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So that's why we praise Him, because He got all by Himself. I'm going to just share one last song. And this song is just reminds us. I did a teaching about holiness, and I even spoke about it at the Open Door Ministry, that God wants us to be holy, amen?
Yeah.
And our job after, I was talking to Pastor Gary today, and I told him, he said, yeah, but it doesn't work without, the power works by God. I said, yeah, but we know that part. I told him this just today, I said, we know it works by God. What's the next step? What's our next step? Amen. Once you come to know Christ as your personal Lord and your Savior, the next step is holiness. Move towards holiness. And this song just is a simple reminder, amen, that we are to walk in holiness with God. Amen. I hope this is one for my lower nature finds to dominate.
I went there When my mother died, all the land that they had was left to me. So I had to go there and sign the rights for my land and everything. My cousin in Austin would pay the property tax every year. It wasn't much. But a month ago, the company that drills oil said, Philip, we think there might be oil on your land. We're going to text you the paper. You need to sign the paperwork. And I told them, I'm in Los Angeles. So they text me the paperwork about a week and a half ago. And I had to fax it to them. They said, Philip, yes, there is land on your oil. There is oil on your land. We have the paperwork. We don't know how much, but you do have a lot of oil on your land. It's your land. And so we'll keep you posted when they do the drilling, just how much it's worth. So I'm just praying that God will bless me, that I have a Beverly Hillbillies moment. But they said there is oil on my land, and they're going to send the paperwork to me to sign for the drill.
Praise the Lord.
God
can do it. What
do
you do?
Hello, my name is Lilia Fierro. I am from Chicago. I come from a drug addict, alcoholic family. But I broke the chains. I broke the chains. It hasn't been easy. Because the demon, the devil, the bad influence is behind me all the time. But we're, you know, like I always say, you know, greater is he that is on earth than the one that is in the world. And you know, here is going to be a change, a big change, and it's still going on. But we have to keep being faithful. We have to keep being together, not because you're Mexican, you're American. No. You know, in the eyes of the Lord, we all the same. We all, you know, I had money. I had. Now I'm like you. You know, I'm homeless. But I never been homeless because my God, you know, I always say, I serve a mighty God. Yes, I serve a mighty God. We all serve a mighty God. May God bless you and keep you strong.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Anybody else like to say something good God has done for you or something you've been through, a testimony? Anybody have a testimony about
All right, praise the Lord, church. I'm going to be alive because the wife wanted to sell me to the placement, and that's a blessing for God, you know what I mean? So now me and my old dog, we talk, so that's the best friend, I love you.
Amen.
Amen. Now I say I got blessed to the wife on it.
Oh, you got blessed.
Yep, all right. Blessed.
So I'd like to say something about anything that God has done for you. Well, I just want to say, set me free from sex, drugs, and alcohol. And I'm grateful today. I just thank God because I opened the door up for so much damage to happen and so much to happen to me. I summed myself up. You know, I was strung out there on heroin, cocaine, and everything, just shooting dope, running the streets, neglecting my children, doing it. What you do when you do that. But I thank God.
Yes.
It is hard. But I thank God he's brought me to this point. At least to this point, you know. I don't have the craving, the urge for that anymore. And I thank God every moment, every morning I wake up and don't have the craving for alcohol, drugs, heck, none of that. I crave Jesus. I want more and more of Jesus. And the way I serve the Satan out there, the way I'm going to serve Jesus in here, the same way. So I just got to say, he delivered me, but he's still delivering me. He's still working on me. There's things I personally have to work on for personally. But he personally helps me. Because he's my personal Lord and Savior. He's personal. I get personal with him. So I'm grateful for that. You know, he's taking care of my family. All while I was out there, he take care of all while I was serving. And I just want to thank him. And I just give him all glory and honor and let you know that as long as you serve him, he'll watch over your family too. Because you don't know, if he calls you to go somewhere, you need to be ready to go. Because Jesus don't sit still. You can go home. You see that today? He'll have you going. Because you need to be in places. This is a dying generation, really.
Yes, Lord.
And it's going to hell. Yes. So, and hell ain't no joke. Hell is real. It's in the Bible. The Bible says it's enlarging every day. Yes. So that means that people is going to hell, dying, going to hell every day. And I don't want to be one. I'm not going to be one in the name of Jesus. Just Father God said, just confess with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that Jesus died and he rose again.
Amen.
And you believe that, you shall be saved. So that's what I do. And I believe that. So I thank God for salvation tonight. Deliverance tonight. Healing. He healed my body from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. He really did. He healed my body. So I thank him for that. Now, does anyone else have anything they would like to thank him for? Or just anything you'd like to say about the Lord? You would?
Come on.
Come, I'll come to you. I'll come right back here. I want to hear it all. We need to hear you. Yes. You probably can't get it.
Filter so much.
Jesus lives. I can face tomorrow.
Yes.
Because he lives.
for this church.
Amen.
This is my third time. Yeah, and the praise and worship just kind of like take you up into another place. Because the praising God,
amen.
Hallelujah. When you praise God, then you bring God's presence into your presence.
Uh-huh.
And those two presences meet together. This is like an explosion.
Amen.
So just stand your ground and just keep your faith in yourself and believe in yourself. The Almighty God got you, and no matter what, we have angels around you guys. So thank you guys for showing up and showing out for this Friday night. Well, it's been a hectic week all this week for those who have been around. It's been fires and it's been shootings and everything else. But you have to rebuke it and cast that out in the name of Jesus that you guys will be safe no matter what. And thank you for the ladies, the young ladies that always come out and show forth. And you guys are blessing. They got blessings here for you guys. So, the men that's in the house, you guys are going to be blessed. So, they have little gifts in here and there. So, I'm going to let these ladies go ahead and introduce themselves for those that don't know them. They come out to the church here
every
few Fridays. So, I'm going to go ahead and let them. Introduce themselves so they
can go ahead and bless
you
guys
with a blessing.
Sit down.
Hi, I'm Ashley, and this is Melissa. We gather in the community, and they just want to bless you guys.
Jesse Lee and
Sailor. We see the need, so we ask for donations for our blankets, our pillows today. We have toilet stuff.
Miss Jessie Lee and Sailor will give me money.
Thank you.
It will be visible at all times until I get my money. Yeah, sha. I say that in the nicest way possible. Sorry, I'm fighting my ex. Not fighting. Passing
us. Everybody, you can have some peace. A little bit of peace here in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, we can just have some peace. Just keep it down. Respect the house of the Lord right now in Jesus' name. You speak the name Jesus. Now, anybody else? Would anybody else like to say anything about Jesus? Would you like to say something about Jesus while you're talking?
No, because the way I am, I'm
going to. That's why he died.
Because
his name.
Hey, sure. He got to say something right here.
Yeah, Jesus ain't worried about that.
Hello, guys. My name is Farrell Gillis. I've been coming to this church for a long time. And I will be here and I will keep my people here right. So you guys, please come here and take care of yourselves. Because we're in the streets for a reason. And God loves you. Jesus loves you. He's here for you. He's here to help us all. All of us need the help, so we're here for a reason, so act like you're here for a reason, right? Please politely walk out and don't disturb the negotiation with the church, because we're here for you. Now, thank you for what you guys are doing. Please proceed and be safe, because Jesus loves you. Come here in the Lord's house. Don't start it, because I will put you on a pillow. God bless you. Stay safe. Be strong. And we'll be here for you when you need us.
Amen. 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 God be the glory.
God has blessed me with writing songs. And a few years ago, there's a song I wrote about King David. You know, when Samuel went to anoint the next king, they called everyone in except for David. He was out in the field. And he said, and Samuel said, "This isn't the one." And so he said, "Do you have another son?" He said, "Well, it's David, but he's out in the field." He said, "Bring him." And they poured the oil and they said, "No, this is going to be the next king, King David." There's a song I wrote called Jesse, If I Told You, because Jesse was David's father. You forgot, it was called Jesse, If I Told You. Go like this. Jesse, if I told you that your baby boy will be king, they will name a star for him, in his honor they will sing. Giants will fall and a kingdom will rise. He'll win many battles because he found favor in God's eyes. Jesse, if I told you, Jesse, if I told you, Jesse, if I told you that from the very start, he'll be overlooked by man, but be a man after God's own heart. Not because he's the tallest, the strongest, almost brave, but mighty God has called him that a nation will be saved. Jesse, if I told you, Jesse, if I told you, Jesse, if I told you, through your bloodline God will raise up his only son for us, that all mankind could be saved. So when you see your baby boy out in the fields with sheep, know that God has called him, and your baby boy God will keep. Jesse, if I told you, Jesse, if I told you, Jesse, if I told you.